Evening, Jürgen. Earlier today, speaking to Carlo Ancelotti, he said he felt that Liverpool had gone up a level, obviously since the friendly, but from what he'd seen for Liverpool in the Premier League, and believes now that you're one of the most consistent and among the elite in Europe. Just how does that make you feel when you have an assessment for somebody like Ancelotti? He feels you've gone up a level since last year.
Question first?
No, you answer.
Oh, I answer.
Yes, please.
So I had a few interviews already out there for television stations, and they all said they were so positive. They told me that Carlo was so positive, and it only... So we can start with that. I like Carlo Ancelotti. I respect him a lot, and he's a fantastic guy. He was a world-class player. He's a world-class manager. And how we in Germany say he's obviously a smart fox. Giving all these very positive things about us and then saying all these nice things about me before a game. It's nice, actually, but it's tactics. That's already. Carlo is so long in the business and he wants to try to bring the nice fella out of me. Let me say like this, and I'm here to be ready for a real battle and stuff like that. So I don't care too much what people say about us in the moment and how they see our situation. Yes, we were stable in the last few weeks. We performed on a consistent, okay level. But again, tomorrow we need to step up. We need to make the next step in that development, because this is a fantastic manager, a fantastic football team, and a very, very emotional crowd. So that will be a real challenge. And now we have to wait for the translation, probably.
Carlo Ancelotti oggi nella conferenza stampa ha detto che il Liverpool è salito di livello, che credo ormai sia una delle squadre più continue del panorama internazionale. Come ti fa sentire una cosa del genere da un allenatore di questo livello? Beh, mi hanno fatto le stesse domande, mi hanno riportato le stesse parole anche dalle televisioni, tante cose positive, quindi comincerò a dire che sicuramente mi piace Carlo Ancelotti, lo rispetto molto, ovviamente ha allenato dei grandissimi club, però fatemi dire, anche come abbiamo detto in tedesco, insomma è anche una buona volpe. Dire tante cose molto carine, alla fine sono solamente delle tattiche. Quindi lui è da parecchio tempo in questo business, però anch'io ormai da un po', che so che quindi insomma queste cose fanno parte del gioco per cercare di addolcirmi, ma in fin dei conti noi dobbiamo semplicemente salire di livello domani, perché ci aspetta una partita molto difficile in uno degli stadi con un'atmosfera incredibile, e quindi dobbiamo solamente pensare a fare bene.
Next one from Sky.
Jürgen, just a huge debate at the moment within football about the relationship between the manager and the group of players that work under you, work with you, and how it's changed. Just wondering whether it's to talk to them individually as a group or however you do it, how it has changed over the years, and what's your philosophy about that relationship, which is so key, between a manager and his players?
I'm not as smart as Carlo Ancelotti, but I'm smart enough to not answer this question in these times, because we all know what you all would make of all the things I could say about this, and that's why I will not answer the question.
C'è tanto dibattito al momento sulla relazione di come la gestione fra l'allenatore, il gruppo e come è cambiato in questi ultimi anni. Qual è il tuo parere a riguardo? Non sono così furbo come Carlo Ancelotti, però sono furbo abbastanza da non dover rispondere a questa domanda, quindi preferisco non rispondere.
Buonasera, mister. Allora, Massimiliano Guerriero, TV Luna. Lorenzo Insigne in conferenza stampa ha detto: spero di far gol a Klopp come 5 anni fa. E poi sulla domanda: il calciatore più pericoloso del Liverpool secondo te chi è? Lui ha risposto: Firmino.
Today in press conference, Lorenzo Insigne said he was very happy and he's still got a good memory of the goal that he scored 5 years ago against one of your team, and then he also said that what the player that he fears the most of your squad is Firmino.
Okay. Where's the question?
Dove la domanda?
Cosa pensi di Insigne se ricordi quel gol di 5 anni fa?
So, what do you think of Insigne and if you remember the goal from 5 years ago?
I think Insigne is an outstanding player, and that's for a pretty long time already, and I remember a lot of games because I had to analyze him a few times. And yeah, he's still fantastic. That's how it is. Unfortunately, I don't remember the goal. I have kind of a filter in my brain. Bad things I forget immediately. So, and if he would have scored for my team, then I would remember it 100%, but so I don't know it anymore. So that's it. But he's not the only really good player in that team, but he is one of the really good ones. So that makes it so difficult. Napoli is really good organized, quality in all departments, defense, midfield, offense, speed, good in dribbling, technical wise really strong, and that makes it a really good football team. The good news for us is we are not too bad as well, and that's why I'm looking forward to the game, but it will still be difficult for both of us. Who is talking there when you see?
Lorenzo Insigne è un giocatore eccezionale, lo sappiamo. Sono passati tanti anni, 5 anni, ma comunque si è dovuto studiare molto per analizzare questa partita. Non mi ricordo benissimo i dettagli di quel gol, ma semplicemente perché il mio cervello filtra solamente le cose buone, le cose belle, e cerca di rimuovere direttamente tutte quante le cose positive. Insomma, se è qualcosa di buono per la mia squadra me lo ricordo al 100%. Però non è il solo giocatore forte del Napoli, sono molti i giocatori forti, è una squadra molto organizzata in tutti e tre i settori, sono veloci, sono forti nei dribbling, sono forti tecnicamente, ma la buona notizia per noi è che siamo anche noi molto preparati e che quindi sarà una partita difficile per entrambe le squadre.
You mentioned it being quite an emotional stadium, it was quite an emotional match for you the last time you were here. Could just tell us your memories and how hopeful are you that you won't watch the second half tomorrow with the groundsman?
It was one of the better experiences I had, to be honest, watching it with the groundsman. I heard he's still here, that would be nice. We couldn't speak that much that time, we cannot speak much more today because my Italian skills are not better than 5 years ago, and probably his English or German is not better. But it was, yeah, how can I say it? It was not my best performance, personally. I reacted in a way which was absolutely not okay. I still understand why I was not happy with the situation, only the reaction was a bit too much. And then they gave me, I don't know anymore, 2 games? No, I had 2 games for sure, not only 1 game. I had to go here, and I watched 2 games from the stand. One was against Arsenal at home, and I don't know where was the other game, but I'm pretty sure it was not the shortest. But it was because my behavior before that was not too good as well, especially in the German Bundesliga. Since then, nothing happened anymore. So it was my, I don't know how you say it, but it was my last time when I was a bit too excited. And now I know it will not happen again. But yeah, it was in Napoli. And I tried to go on the stand because they sent me on the stand the first half already, and I went there. And it was not nice sitting there and getting all the comments from all the people around. And that's why I decided second half I have to do something different. And I was then with the groundsman in that little room with a big Maradona shirt on the wall. And I heard now there's a Marco Reus shirt next to it. So good to know that a few things are the same and a few things changed in a better way.
Allora, per te è sempre stata un po' una partita emotiva, quella di 5 anni fa, te la ricordi in una maniera sicuramente emotiva. Quanto vuoi cercare di riuscire ad arrivare a vederti il secondo tempo dalla panchina e non farti espellere? Sì, mi ricordo ancora quella partita, mi ricordo che sono finito a vederla qui all'interno con il custode dello stadio. Spero che sia ancora qui con loro, con noi. È stata una partita interessante, siamo stati solamente lui non parlava né tedesco né inglese, io ovviamente non parlavo italiano, quindi non ci siamo riusciti molto a capire, però è stata sicuramente un'esperienza interessante. Ovviamente non è stata una delle mie migliori performance, una delle migliori serate, mi ha portato a due giornate di squalifica, oltre a non aver finito di vedere, ovviamente di finire in panchina la partita stessa, credo una con l'Arsenal, la seconda sinceramente non mi ricordo, però molto è cambiato da allora. Penso anche che quella abbia funzionato anche un po' da lezione, so che quelle cose non devo farle più. Mi ricordo poi, insomma, finì in tribuna subito dopo l'espulsione, non fu una buona idea perché fui circondato dai tifosi del Napoli, insomma non mi dicevano certamente delle buone cose, quindi ho finito il resto della partita guardando la partita con il custode in questa stanza dove mi ricordo c'erano le magliette di Maradona. Comunque molto è passato da allora.
Last couple before Gini. When Alvin comes in, gentlemen here, and then we go to the gentleman at the back. Yes, please.
Buonasera, mister. Lei ha allenato prima del Liverpool il Borussia, due club con tifosi molto passionali e caldi. Domani il San Paolo sarà pieno come era pieno nel 2013. Le volevo chiedere se lei ha mai avuto l'impressione che il fattore ambientale in una singola partita abbia in qualche modo ridotto il gap tra una squadra e quella in teoria più forte. Grazie.
You coach two teams, Borussia and Liverpool, that are famous to have two very, very passionate crowds. Tomorrow, like 5 years ago, again there will be full stadium, passionate crowd. Do you think the fact that the atmosphere and the crowd can help reduce the gap between teams that have a wide gap?
Only two things. I had another very good club before that. It was Mainz 05. Very passionate fans as supporters as well. Then, if there would be a gap, then it would. Then it always helps. I don't see a gap between Napoli and us, to be honest. But if there would be a gap, it helps. If the mix-up is good between the football you play and the atmosphere in the stadium, then it's always a benefit. That's how it is, 100%. And I believe in that, and I enjoy that actually. And but on the other hand side, it's not that a team cannot perform in a very emotional stadium as an away team. Teams are doing that in Anfield, absolutely, and so we try to do that tomorrow here as well. But we are aware of emotions in the stadium, and we try to bring in ours, and because this tournament is for us really important, and hopefully we can see that.
Prima ancora del Borussia c'era stata un'altra squadra che è il Mainz, che ha comunque sia una tifoseria anche quella molto, molto appassionata. Diciamo, ovviamente l'atmosfera è importante, però fammi dire, non vedo un grande gap fra noi e il Napoli. Poi devo dire, l'atmosfera può anche piacerti, può anche caricarti. Ma non è che un team che gioca fuori casa è particolarmente condizionato. Sicuramente siamo coscienti delle emozioni, siamo coscienti di quello che ci sarà domani qua, però l'importante è trovare le nostre di emozioni da mettere in campo.
Ok, jump with the microphone and then we bring Gini.
Sera. La partita amichevole di quest'estate, vinta 5-0 dal Liverpool, può rappresentare per il Liverpool più un esempio da seguire o un pericolo perché magari rischia di sottovalutare in qualche modo inconsciamente il Napoli?
The friendly you played in July against Napoli, could it be an example to follow or could it be a danger for perhaps being too complacent?
Neither, no. It was a pre-season friendly, nothing else, in Dublin, in a wonderful stadium surrounding very Liverpool orientated, I would say. And we scored with each shot pretty much, and Napoli had a lot of chances, didn't score with that, had scored a goal, which linesman or whoever gave offside, which was no offside. So. That's absolutely not important. We didn't talk about that game 1 second so far. And no, he remembered me, so I will maybe tell the boys, ignore it, because I, and that has nothing to do with the preparation for that game, because how is that, preseason friendly, if we would have lost it. Last year, wasn't it last year in the preseason, we beat Barcelona at Wembley 4-0. Next day, we went to Mainz and lost at Mainz 4-0. And Barcelona was still a world-class team, and Mainz was not better than Liverpool. It's pre-season, that's all.
No, era semplicemente una partita di amichevole estiva, stagionale. Nessuno dei due possono essere né l'esempio né il pericolo, insomma. È stata semplicemente una bella amichevole a Dublino, in un bel posto, con tantissimi, ovviamente, una grossa presenza di tifosi del Liverpool. Credo che noi in quella partita abbiamo segnato praticamente su tutti i tiri che abbiamo fatto, mentre il Napoli non è riuscito a segnare nonostante che avesse avuto quasi pari occasioni. Tra l'altro hanno anche segnato su un fuorigioco che non era nemmeno un fuorigioco. Quindi dirò semplicemente di ignorare quella partita ai miei giocatori. Vi faccio un esempio: la stagione precedente avevamo fatto due amichevoli, una contro il Barcellona, abbiamo vinto 4-0, subito dopo abbiamo giocato contro il Mainz, abbiamo perso per lo stesso risultato. Quindi si tratta semplicemente di partite prestagionali di cui non hanno molta importanza.
Marco, please apologize to the people whose questions we haven't been able to take them to the club, but Gini Wijnaldum coming out and taking questions.
Thank you very much. Ci scusiamo per il numero di domande, adesso dobbiamo fare il viaggio.
Good evening. Hi there. Could I just ask a question about where you think Liverpool are at? Because Carlo Ancelotti earlier today believes Liverpool have stepped up a level. It'd be really interesting to hear from the players' point of view. Do you believe as players that you have stepped up a level from last season, that you are a better, more consistent team?
Yes, of course. I think also because of the results that we happening right now. We played some tough games already during the season. I think the games against Huddersfield at home, where we just had a lead of 1-0, and we still managed to win it. It was really difficult. Crystal Palace away during the years was really difficult to win there. Also, the game against Paris Saint-Germain. I think at the end, a lot of people thought that it's going to be 2-2, but we still managed to win the game 3-2. So I think that we show with those games that we step up in experience, but I think we have to keep it a whole season. So the season is long. I hope we can do it. So that means we will get better results.
A che punto pensi si trova questa squadra al momento? Carlo Ancelotti oggi nella conferenza stampa ha detto il Liverpool mai è salito di un livello, sta mostrando più continuità. Secondo te dove si trova al momento la squadra? Sicuramente gli ultimi risultati aiutano parecchio, insomma siamo riusciti a dimostrare in partite molto difficili, mi vengono in mente la partita contro l'Huddersfield, la partita contro il Crystal Palace, anche la stessa partita contro il PSG, sono state partite molto difficili, molto toste, però abbiamo dimostrato la convinzione di cercare di ribaltarle e portare a casa il risultato. Questo sicuramente dimostra un salto avanti, però alla fine dobbiamo comunque sia cercare di mantenere una continuità per tutto il resto della stagione.
Daniel Sturridge has really been impressing, especially the last game. Can you just give us some sense of how hard he has worked, maybe behind the scenes, to get himself fit, but also to get the form? And with England having a small pool of players to pick for internationally, how ready do you think he'd be to for an England recall?
I don't know what he did in his pre-season, but when he came back, he was really, really fit. So when I came back, because I came a few days later than the guys, he did quite well. I think better than the years before. So what I just said, I didn't know what he did in his preseason, but he was quite fit. And during the season, he just showed that he is really important for us. Not only because of his goals, but also the way he's playing. I think against Paris Saint-Germain, we saw Sturridge playing in a way we didn't see him before, defending, switched positions with one of the front three, and did their job. So he's really, really good in shape, being fit, in form, and I think he deserved to be in the squad of England.
Domanda su Sturridge, quanto ha fatto molto bene, quanto ha lavorato parecchio per riuscire a ritornare dall'infortunio e soprattutto quanto può essere pronto adesso per l'Inghilterra, soprattutto anche dal fatto per c'è un numero alquanto limitato di scelta per essere il selezionatore della nazionale inglese, quanto è importante poi contare su di lui. Sì, sicuramente sta migliorando molto. Ovviamente siamo arrivati in tempi diversi nella parte della pre-season rispetto a quando è arrivato lui. So solamente che ha lavorato veramente tanto e che adesso si vede che sta veramente molto bene, non tanto per quanto riguarda la parte di realizzare gol, ma semplicemente per quanto aiuta a difendere, aiuta il resto della squadra. È in un'ottima condizione e merita di essere parte di questa squadra.
Nothing can be won in either Champions League or Premier League right now, but there's always a sense that things could be lost. Just how big a week is this for Liverpool? Champions League here tonight, but then also you just got a few days before a huge test against Manchester City. Just already, how big a week is this for Liverpool? Napoli, then Manchester City in the Premier League.
To be fair, we're now only busy with the game against Napoli, and after that we will look at the game against Manchester City. We just can manage one game at a time. We only can control our performance against Napoli now, so I think it's better to concentrate against concentrate on the game against Napoli, and then we will look at Manchester. But of course, it's a really, really important week, but I think the period after the international break, we already know that it's going to be really important because we're going to play against tough opponents. But what I just said, I think it's better to keep your head on one game, and then when that one is done, you will think about the other one.
È vero che siamo solamente all'inizio, insomma, ma quanto è importante questa settimana con due partite fondamentali, una contro il Napoli e subito dopo contro il City? Cominciate già a giocare qualcosa di importante per entrambe le due competizioni. Quanto è importante per te? Per noi adesso conta solamente il Napoli, poi dopo cominceremo a guardare la partita col City. È sempre meglio guardare una partita alla volta, meglio concentrarsi su questa partita, sulla partita di domani contro il Napoli. Ovviamente è una settimana importante, ma per noi la tensione c'è sempre. Una volta dopo il City avremo poi il break con le partite nazionali, ci saranno altre partite importanti per noi.
Buonasera TV Luna, cosa temi di più del Napoli?
Do you fear more of Napoli? What do you fear more of Napoli?
Everything. I think they have a really good team. We played in pre-season, we played against them. That worked well for us. Not really well for them, but I think the circumstances was also different. Now it's Champions League, you play for something. They play at home, so it's going to be different. They have a lot of good players. what we have to be aware of. So it's going to be a difficult game.
Tutto veramente, sono un'ottima squadra, però abbiamo giocato un amichevole quest'estate, ma era una situazione completamente differente. Adesso ci giochiamo tanto, ci giochiamo la Champions League, ma ripeto, hanno veramente tantissimi giocatori ed è un'ottima squadra.
Jensen, Iannicelli di Canale 21. Qual è invece secondo lei il punto debole del Napoli? L'aspetto sul quale voi lavorerete per cercare di mettere in difficoltà i vostri avversari, e giocherete anche per il pareggio o vi interessa solo la vittoria per chiudere o quasi la questione nel girone?
And instead, what do you think is the weak point of this team, the weak point that we will try to attack on, to explore? And also, will you consider playing for a draw, considering the situation in the group, or you will just go for the win?
It's difficult to say whether they're not good. Every team has its weaknesses. I think it's not good to tell it in a press conference, because then they know what you want to do. But every team have their weaknesses, and we were trying to use that to win this game. And to come back on the question, are you going to play for a draw or to win? We always play games to win and not to play a draw. So also tomorrow we're going to play the game to win it.
Secondo solo. Ovviamente non è molto intelligente dire qui in conferenza stampa quale può essere il punto debole del Napoli. Ovviamente noi sappiamo quello che dobbiamo fare domani e cercheremo di farlo al meglio. Sulla domanda se giocare per il pareggio o per la vittoria, noi giochiamo sempre per la vittoria e domani sarà la stessa cosa.
Buonasera, Marcello Calvano, Radio Kiss Kiss. Tu hai avuto modo di giocare con Dries Mertens al PSV Eindhoven. Ti aspettavi un'esplosione così incredibile di questo calciatore nel ruolo di punta centrale? Ha fatto davvero tantissimi gol negli ultimi anni qui al Napoli, e secondo te le caratteristiche di Mertens e Insigne, qualora dovessero partire titolari domani, potrebbero mettere in difficoltà la difesa del Liverpool, che è molto fisica? Grazie.
You played with Dries Mertens in PSV and in the past. What do you think of him as a player? What do you think was his exploit, having scored so many goals from playing from a central position? And if he's going to play tomorrow in tandem with Insigne, do you think the characteristics of these two players can create some problems to the very physical defense that you have?
When I played with Dries, he already showed that he was a good player. I think the steps that he made in his career, from AGOVV to Utrecht, from Utrecht to PSV, I was lucky at PSV that I could play with him, because I see his development as a player. And at that time he was left winger, scored a lot of goals, was really important for us as a team. And I already know that he could score goals as a left winger, but I didn't know he could score goals as a striker. I think when he changed position to a striker, he did the same like the best players in the world. He scored a lot of goals. I think it was really important for Napoli. So he's a world class player. I think he showed that with his development. And I think every good player, for him and Insigne, if they play on the pitch, they can always make it difficult for opponents. So you just have to be sure that you will be aware of it and trying to defend them as good as possible, because they have the quality to do something for their team.